Are you working remotely while traveling to NYC? I'm Qiana, and in this video, I'm going to share with you 5 hacks for doing business in New York during your visit. Often regarded as a haven for entrepreneurs, New York City startups received $9.9 billion in venture capital investment in 2019. The city's encouragement of its own residents to forge their own path in business has spurred a healthy rate of new entrepreneurs, with approximately 400 out of every 100,000 adults stepping into this role every month. Whether you need a quiet place to take a conference call, opportunities to rub elbows with venture capitalists, or you're just seeking to level up your professional skill set, I have 5 hacks that will come in handy for you during your visit to New York City. Number 1, Jabberbox. Need a quiet place to take a conference call upon arriving to or departing from a New York City airport? Jabberbox is a plush and private workspace that you can book on demand so that you can think, create, connect, and recharge. The Jabberbox concept was inspired by the co-founder's need for private workspace while he was in between meetings in Midtown Manhattan and was unable to find something suitable. You can find Jabberboxes at John F. Kennedy Airport in Terminal 4 and at LaGuardia Airport in Terminal B. Number 2, Tech Breakfast New York. Want to learn about new technologies that may become a part of your everyday life? At Tech Breakfast New York, 5 presenters are given 7 minutes to demo their technology product to an audience who then follows up with questions. The range of technologies demoed are broad, and it's given me an opportunity to learn about helpful apps such as Reserve. Selected presenters do not have to be from New York, so if you have some cool tech to demo, make sure to reach out to the Tech Breakfast New York team and ask them if they can get you on the program. This tech show and tell event takes place every month at a Microsoft event space near Port Authority. Number 3, 3 Den. Up for a co-working space that has a beautiful view of one of New York City's newest tourist attractions? 3Den bills itself as an urban sanctuary that aggregates all the best parts of a coffee shop, hotel lobby, and gym. Using the 3Den app, patrons pay $6 per 30 minutes to access a beautiful workspace, phone booths, napping pods, and showers in the Hudson Yard location that overlooks Vessel, the interactive art exhibit created by Thomas Heatherwick. This is the first of 40 locations that is slated to be in New York City. 3Den is open from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. every day. Number 4, Apple and Microsoft. Ready to level up your skill set? Apple and Microsoft stores in New York City offer free programming so that you can get more out of the products that you love and share your passions with like-minded fans. Microsoft's Fifth Avenue location offers gaming tournaments, youth coding camps, as well as tutorials on programs such as Photoshop. At all of Apple's New York City locations, Today at Apple presents educational programming that focuses on product skills, art design, videos, photography, and music. For more information on locations and programming, click on the links in the description. Number 5, Gary's Guide. In a city that is so diverse, dynamic, and teeming with prospects, how is it even possible to know about all of the wonderful opportunities that are happening right around you? Gary's Guide might help with that. It is a digital resource and community of professionals who are interested in startups, entrepreneurship, social media, and technology. It is one of the best resources for startup and tech-related events, classes, workshops, and jobs in New York City. Gary's Guide reaches a highly targeted mix of influencers and connectors, ranging from startup founders to executives to venture capitalists, angel investors, and even the press. Many of the events listed are low cost or free, and for those that might cost a pretty penny, Gary's Guide sometimes offers free passes, which I've been able to take advantage of. Now, which business trip tip is going to come in most handy for you? Tell me in the comments below. For more detailed information on these hacks for working remotely in New York, click on the links in the description. To receive more NYC travel tips, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and click on the notification bell.